Friends, in this video I'll be helping you with how to convert your hexadecimal number to your octal number. So let's start. So before coming to the problem, you need to know this table very well, because this table will make your work very easy, okay, while you are converting. So let's see the table itself. So this table is your binary representation, and this is your hexadecimal, and this is your octal. So in octal you have total 8 numbers, in hexadecimal you have total 16 numbers, and this is your binary values, okay. So what I have done to make this table is I have taken 4-digit number, 4 zeros, and then I have just added 1, and I have performed that binary addition. Like here you can see, added 1, then 1 plus 1 will be 0 and carry will be 1, okay, then 11 by adding 1, then again I have added 1, so carry 1, 0, 0, okay. So this is how I have made table. So if you will give just 2-3 minutes, you will be able to understand this table very well, okay. And for hexadecimal, it is a 4-digit number, okay. So we can take four digits of this binary, okay. But in case of octal, it is a 3-digit, okay. So what we'll do is we will only pick these 3 digits. That's why I've drawn this line over here, okay. So if you want to see the octal equivalent of your binary, then it will be this. That is, for 0 you can write 000, for 1 you can write 001, for 2 you can write 010, for 3 and for 7 111, okay. So I guess you are clear with your hexadecimal, octal and binary. Now let's start with the conversion, okay. So for example, you have your hexadecimal number as A, B. Remember one thing, after 9 this is 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. So not to create confusion, they use character, okay. So if you have A, B base 16, okay, then what you'll do is you'll write A over here and you'll write B over here, okay, and you will see the equivalent of A and B. So for A it is 1010 and for B it is 1011, okay. So you took out, right? Now what you'll do is, for octal, because it is a 3-digit representation, you will make group of 3 like this, then this and then this. So here you can see there are only 2 digits, so what you'll do is you'll add 0, it will make no change to the value, right? And now you'll match it with this table. So 011, so your 011 is 3, okay. Then 101 is your 5, okay, and 010 is your 2. So your 253 base 8 is your equivalent or octal representation. Let's see another quickly, okay. So let's see another one, like F46 base 16, okay. So we'll do the same thing, F46, and we'll write out the binary equivalent, that is 4 times 1 for F, then for 4 it is 0100 and for 6 it is 0110, okay. Then again we'll make the group of 3 digits, because your octal is a 3-digit number. And here you can see, so 110 will be 6, then your 000 will be your 0 only, 101 will be 5, and 3 times 1 will be 7, so it will be 7506 base 8. So this is how you will be finding from hexadecimal to your octal representation. So if you like the video, do hit the like button, do subscribing, and thanks for watching.